Anger. What's up, guys? Cellier, welcome back to another episode of Hello Zelda Twilight Princess HD. This episode, we got freaking save Colin because freaking King BULBLIN over here is taking him links all angry. Alright, we gotta go. Go, go, go. We gotta freaking save Colin from this ugly freaking BULBLIN. The king of all BULBLINs. And here he is on his freaking signature blue bull with Colin on a spear. This is cool music, isn't it? Oh, he's gesturing us to come. Alright, here we go, boys. Ooh, he's calling in his posse. Alright, time to freaking deal with this scrub. Alright, boys, let's go! Alright, charge up your sword and freaking approach him. Use opponent to the fullest. Yeah! Oh, I missed. It's okay. Just gotta charge up your thing, right? Then use your A things. But it's better if you... These guys kind of get in the way, so it's fine if you take them out. I don't know why opponent like turned around there, but whatever. Alright, buddy. Oh! Yeah, there we go. Alright, charge up the sword. He like slows down for us. So use Epona. Get up real close. Oof! Get a bunch of his armor off. I'd like to keep Z-targeted on him. That is not happening though. Freaking. That guy's knocking me off. I'm coming, King BULBLIN. I'm freaking coming, mate. You're freaking gonna get it. Capturing probably one of my least favorite characters in the game. I mean, he's good on him for like saving Forehead Chick and everything, but like. I mean, that boy. If Mallow was there, he just would have freaking, like, guillotined the King BULBLIN himself and just would have dealt with it easily. So I mean, Mallow's still the best character. Oh, I freaking missed. We should get him here. Guess not. Okay. And we got him. Okay, but that is not everything, because he recovers from falling off the bull. And Link is so angry. And he looks like he hops onto the bridge. But it's okay, because opponent's cool. But, oh, snap. Looks like we freaking got lured into his trap. Reminds me of freaking Helm's Deep for some reason from Lord of the Rings. With the fire and the gates. It's nothing really like Helm's Deep, but... whatever, man. Okay, so this guy... gotta bait him. And, oh. He freaking knocked opponent off as well. I also forgot I was meant to be charging up my sword. Alright, so what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna charge up your sword and bait him. And then quickly go to the other side and wreck him. Just like that. I think you only need to hit him twice. Upon a... Freak. There you go. It was a crazy prank! Ow! We still need to hit him twice again, I think. Oh my god, that takes off a lot of hearts. Yo, if we die here, I'm gonna be triggered. What did I just say? It takes off a full heart when you get hit. Alright. We gotta do this well. There we go. Oh, it sounded like I got hit off. Lol. I got scared there because I thought he hit me off somehow. But yeah, we get the cool freaking pose like at the start of the title screen. With Link on Epona all swag-like. And yeah, man. Looks like we saved kind of an extreme close-up on Link's face. Link? Is everyone okay? Yo, Beth's eyelids are weird as well. Good. Beth, I'm sorry, you know, for shoving you. Are you mad? Oh, it's like, lol, no, you freaking idiot, why would I be mad? I think I finally understand. I understand what my dad meant when he told me I need to be stronger like you, Link. Link is, like, so upset that he has to carry Colin. He wasn't talking about strength, like lifting stuff. He was talking about being brave. Oh, yeah, dude. Who would guess that? You know, punch the air. Link, you saved me, didn't you? Yeah, I did. You can do anything. Dude, freaking Colin's trying to get in with Link. You can do something to help the Gorons in the mine too, can't you, Link? Yeah, probably. Oh, he's dead. He's dead. He's straight up dead. Freaking Tallow over here, being a hero. Tallow already messed up, mate. Sorry, kid. Renato's alright, though. He's gonna go bury the corpse in his backyard, along with Luda and Tallow. Well, that's the last time we're seeing Colin. Spoilers. And now, to honor Colin's last wish, we gotta go up to freaking Death Mountain, man. But before we do that, I wanna go get a bug. Actually, you know, real quick, if you hop in the spring, you can actually get hearts. So I'll cut here when I get full hearts. And we're back with full hearts. It's helpful because the water just heals you from standing in it. But yeah, screw Colin and his death. Colin on his deathbed over there. We're gonna freaking go get an ant. Because ants are more important than Colin's death. Hashtag screw Colin. Just kidding. Alright, like these. And we'll get a chest. Sadly, it does not have a piece of heart in it, though. It just has, I believe, a purple rupee. Yeah, purple rupee. Okay. And then we'll come up here. Right here's the ant that we were looking for. A male ant. Cool, man. So I think that's our fifth bug. Yeah, because we got the pill bugs, and then we got the beetles, and that's our ant. Okay. I think there's like... 2, 4, 6, 8... There's either 24 bugs, or there's... freaking... 18 bugs. Wait, no. Hold on, let me math. I can't remember how many slots are in each thing anyway, so whatever. So if you come in here real quick, there is another bug on the floor, and it is the female ant. See you, man. Actually, let's just freaking check the collection screen. Because I haven't showed off the bug menu. Okay, yeah, so... Oh my god, there's a lot more than I thought. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times... 1, 2, 3, 4, 24. Okay. Wait, was that 5? Okay, 4. 25. 24. 24, guys. 24 bugs. And we got 6. We'll get, like, every bug pretty quick. Like, probably we'll have every bug by, like, the 5th temple. And then we won't get the, other one till, like, right after the 6th. But I forgot to do something. I gotta go freaking buy a shield. And what the heck? Has Malomart taken over? Dinner store, dealing in everything from housewares to gently used items. What? Mal's face is all over. Wait. That doesn't mean... No way. Excuse me. Is anyone here? Pick up.
Hey. You can look at stuff, but don't you dare just take things. That's my valuable merchandise. You want it, you pay for it. I decided to take on this unmanned shop. Buy something. It helps the whole village when you do.
Okay, Mallow. Sure, man. So, wooden shield is crappy, and you can buy infinite of them. But we want the Highland shield. Cost us 200 rupees. But it's the best shield in the game, so there you go. Got the Highland shield. Get this pretty early.
Maybe I can't become a hero, but I figure I can help out with heroic business deals. You better work hard, too.
Yeah, I sure will, man. Heroic business deals for life. And with that, now we don't have to use our crappy wooden Ordon shield. Whoops. We can equip our Hylian shield. And look all fancy, fancy dandy, man. And another thing I'd like to show off is, in here, if we go to the fireplace where we killed one of the bugs, there's actually a little thing that not very many people know about. Look who it is. It's the freaking postman. I dropped a letter into the hot spring and now I can't read it. Gotta blow this thing dry. You're gonna like singe it, dude. Is there anything up here? I don't think there is. No, that's just the hole that I came through as a wolf. But actually, up here is where you get the rupees from rolling into the stuff. Oh, it looks like Colin's not dead. He's just dying. Now you want to see the Goron's link? I'm sorry you have to do it. Oh, wait, sorry. I'm sorry you have to do this. Do you have to do the task for us? I'll be here with Colin, so please do not worry about him. Thanks, Renato. Screw freaking Luda. In her sassy voice. But let's freaking make it up to the Gorons, shall we? And yeah, let's go scale Death Mountain. That should be pretty fun, man. So those things look like seaweed, which is weird because we're not in the ocean. If you couldn't tell. But yeah, man. Now that we got the iron boots, that we better equip. We can freaking come up here. And, get the freaking cool Death Mountain music.
Ho! You are back again, human! You will never pass. You cannot hope to match brute force.
Yeah, mate, I can't with the iron boots. Ooh. Yeah, get out of here. I'm, like, dusts off his hands and looks super angry, dude. Yeah, you can, like, you don't have to deal with them. Like, you can get hit by them. Which, I don't know. Kind of saves time sometimes, but I'll just do it anyway. See, freaking Link throws the Gorons. You know what's weird, right? So, like, Link can lift the Gorons with the Iron Boots, but the Iron Boots don't affect his, like, forearms and, like, bicep strength. How the heck does he lift them? Aren't they, like, a ton? They're literally made out of rock, so it doesn't really make a lot of sense. I mean, I can understand stopping them because he has, like, all the weight on his feet. Also, there's a freaking ton of, Bulblins here. Hell. That just try and shoot fire arrows at you, but it's okay because they just don't do that much damage. Link's tunic is on fire. Excuse me, Link, just stop, drop, and roll, man. There you go. I don't think that actually affects it. But I can't tell if that's doing damage to me or not. I think it is. Bust open these, and okay. I wanted the hearts, but okay. Guess we're gonna have to watch a cutscene. Looks like there's a freaking meteor shower. Other Gordon's like, oh man, look, it's that guy. And he's like, alright, you get on my back and you can hop up, alright? And that shows us that if we hop on the Goron, we can go up. So we just have to get him down somehow, huh? Oh, Goron, get away, please. Oh, look at, haha. Freaking meteors thinking they can kill me. LOL. This is funny. Oh, God, We got a homing giant meteor. Yeah, so we'll use this later. Just keep this in mind. We'll come back to this. Whoa, this looks dangerous. Is this traditional Death Mountain welcome? Yeah, Midna, it totally is. Alright, so handle these guys. You just freaking let them attack you, and then you can stand on them. Well, you knock them down, and then you can stand on them. So you just block their attack with your shield, jab them in the belly, and you can hop up. And they'll launch you wherever you're facing. So if you try and, like, look the other way, you will launch that way. So, make sure to look where you want to go. So yeah, man, it's looking kind of cool in the night. There's, like, a real nice hot spring down there, but we can't use that yet. Oh, please, no. Okay, didn't mean to take out that. I meant to put my boots on. I believe that actually this is faster with your iron boots than walking. I never even knew that if you have your boots on and you get launched, then it like launches you like nowhere. It's funny. This will launch me forward, right? Yes, thank God. Whew, that's scary. I just said it's faster to do that, and then I stopped doing it. Alright, let's go. It looks really weird, though. So how come Link has... He struggles with walking with the iron boots, right? But also apparently freezes time. Because that heart stopped floating, so he has trouble walking, but he can jump like the same height. Well, I wouldn't say the same height, but you know, this is an insane speedrunning tactic, man. Okay. Alright, man, go up here. Hey, man, what's that over there? Oh, man, I don't want to do that. Ow. Freak out, we got Mike Tyson over here. I don't want to miss this jump up, please. Just, like, chill. Okay, cool. Alright, now, we can stand up here in victory. And please don't let me fall off. Okay, thank God. So, if we go in here, whoops, I was meant to put on my boots there, but whatever, it doesn't really matter. Oh man, freaking what, dude? 6 at once?
Enough! Is this young one such an imposing enemy that you must all gang up on him? I think not, little brothers.
I gotta give him like a deep enough voice, cause he's like the elder, but he's not the elder.
I am a Goron elder, little human. I am called Gorkoron.
Gorkoron.
Because of certain circumstances, I must lead the Goron tribe in place of Darbus, our tribal patriarch. Tell me, little human, do you come from the village below? You have done well to come this far. You are strong for a human. However, the mines beyond here are not sacred. Sacred to my tribe. Outsiders are not allowed unless.
Oh, the mines beyond here are sacred. Unless. What, you want me to freaking sumo wrestle you? Because that's what you're into?
Hehe, he knows. I could make an exception, but you would have to beat me in a contest of power. Are you willing to try that, little human?
Of course, man. Alright, time for sumo with Chaboy. He already has his diaper on. Whole ground shakes when he stumps his legs. And then when Link does it, he'll like make like the slightest shake. Like there's such a light shake you won't even see it. Lol. I bet if you blinked you already missed it. Alright, so first of all what we gotta do is freaking. Alright, let's dodge his attack, alright? And, oh my god.
Your body is skinny, brother, and so you are too light. You do not stand a chance. Try again later, brother.
I sure will, mate. But, excuse me, sir, can I, fight you again, please?
Yeah, what is it? Do you want to try again, little human?
Yes, please.
Now, if you put the iron boots on, you think you are tough, do you? Let us find out.
Now we can battle him as if he was Bo, but he is a lot harder than Bo. I'm gonna slap him straight up. Got him. Alright, now since he's cowering by the ledge, we should be able to slap him. Oh, okay, never mind. He read me too hard. I'm gonna grab him here. Grab. Slap. Grab. Yeah, there we go. I'm gonna dodge him here. What? Okay, I'm gonna grab. Yep, there we go. Alright, I should be able to slap here. Oh, he read me too hard, man. Dude, what a professional. Dodge. Ooh. Check this out. And slap. Got him. Boom. First try, boys. Link's super angry as always. Link's eyebrows are on fleek.
Young warrior, you have a strong will and sharp eyes. Fine traits. Want to see how well you can use them?
Yeah, man.
You have seen it. I would bet the mountain erupting without pause. When the mountain began to rage, all four of us elders and Darbus, our patriarch, went inside to investigate its anger.
I know that Darbus is your patriarch. You don't have to say it again.
We have a treasure that was entrusted to us by the spirits, and we must protect it. Do you understand? But the moment Darbus reached out and touched the treasure, everything went wrong. He collapsed and before our very eyes transformed into an unspeakable monster. He began to rage through the mines, trailing ruin behind him, and the eruptions grew more frequent and more severe. We used all of our strength to seal him deep inside the mountain. It grieved us to do this to our patriarch.
Okay, I get it. He's your patriarch.
But we had no other course of action. I guess this favor of you, young warrior, go to the aid of Darbus. Don't forget he's our patriarch. Make no mistake, the spirits have guided you here. I, Gorkoron, need your help. On behalf of my entire clan, I ask you for your aid. Hey. You too. Let the young warrior pass.
Alright, sir. So yeah, that'll be it for this episode. So now we can stand here all cool with the Gorons. Being all thugs with the bodyguards. Yeah, I'm a bouncer. I'm with these guys. Anyway, make sure you guys enjoyed this episode, and if you did, please drop a like and subscribe for more. Who cares, man? Oh, the Patriarch's location. Don't forget our Patriarch Darbus. So in the next episode, we'll be going into the Goron Mines. Make sure to drop a like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!